idea. How?
Yes, yes.
So we put the framework of the idea cooperation here. Here we have the two pictures here. This one is divided by 2. This one is now currently 25% productivity and 65% for them. Now our idea is changed, transformed into this.
Second one is now a challenge. PLM debt service ratio is too high now. So the best for how to restructure the investment structure. In the past, the paradigm is all of the things should be established together. Now, invite all entrepreneurs or team changers to do together, participate. And the regulation now has been clear by ministry decree, something like this. It's been possible to participate this for all entrepreneurs.
Also for international
investors.
Equity can is enabled. I mean, the primary sources to leverage that is already technology, smaller marketplaces.
Yes, I think it is. And also now it's been in place in other countries like the Northern Europe, in the South America, with small devices, monetize energy, and gives the services to the
customers. So the business model, would you apply, I mean, the normal way of this word, microfinancing projects in developing nations, and that you would provide small but quite expensive money sources to local entrepreneurs for leveraging, I mean, the energy, I mean, the local grids.
Yes,
that's what we do.
Yeah, because now in Indonesia, actually, if you don't, the product is very high, the market characteristic in the outside of Java, actually, is localized.
What do you think? Would any one of you invest in this project?
I have one question.
Yes.
Well, apologies for me becoming a complainer.
You should. Skeptical people are
For example, the electricity in Indonesia, probably you also have the experience of it's
certain technologies are moving faster than everything. Many of them are. chance for extra revenues. I mean, we talked about it before as well. The game changes to try to find spots where the gap between production costs and perceived consumer value is made. For government companies, it's a complicated proposition. Taxpayers already pay themselves for existence.
But now, technology has some try to different communication. If you come in, we invest like this, they will ask you about the regulation. But if we talk to them, when we come in, when the market growing,
yes,
and then we will make a lot of plans in the future, and he will support us. This is how also we try to change the communication with the local.
Yes.
During the discussion, we understand that not only the energy sector, but also the telecom sector, I believe that both telecom and energy is the industry that highly regulated. And so in this case, during the discussion, we also discussed about the strength and the position of the association. Because association is the only way also to impose on the new regulation. Because without the regulation, also this kind of structure will not work.
Going back to a very other important point I tried to make before as well, which is the co-competition is of course the concept which is a necessity when it comes to regulatory shaping. You're much more powerful if you join forces, of course, and then you become a regulatory shaping vehicle. It will be much more, it's very important for the government if all the leading actors have a joint opinion, then of course that's a very influential organization to make a point. So I also want to comment on this particular setup. When I think about these game-changing initiatives and we orient to places like Live Energy, I think that the places where we make money might not be in the prime sales of energy capacity or distribution of that. It might be in other surrounding systems. We briefly talked about, for example, GE is a quite interesting phenomenon. GE makes 120% of its profit from GE Capital. So it's actually a bank subsidizing bad business to sell expensive loans. So the whole GE has become a bank that forces customers into bad loans with subsidizing bad businesses. That has been the case for a long time for GE. So the financing of infrastructure, for example, is probably a place where you can earn more money and actual distribution or delivery or production of energy, for example.
Yes, you mean the money like space between us?
Space between the cost of producing a loan,
yes,
and the perceived customer value. Because if I can introduce something that improves my life on a video somewhere, if I could get an expensive loan from this guy, I still might perceive that as extremely affordable. Because the technology by effect and my life changed as a consequence of this financial. So I think in many of these game-changing models, one also probably have to rethink where is the main money made. And often it's in another place than you were before. If you earn money on the distribution and production of energy, you might actually earn your money on financing the infrastructure that enables another type of localized production and distribution of energy. So, of course, financing is one aspect. You can also earn money on other features of such a change. Type of services enabled by energy, which is more effectively distributed across countries like Indonesia, enables other type of services that can generate other type of profits. And of course, as the migrant and the owner of such initiative, you can take positions that are interesting when this is happening. Because being the game changer, you're the one shaping the game, which means that you are a little bit before others, seeing what will be the future, meaning you can take positions that are more interesting. Because having equity in something that do not have high profitability, according to an economist, is not an asset, it's more liability. So sometimes there's a strive for equity in industrial structures, which are mostly a big heavy burden to us. Because if anything changed on the market, you only have margins of a couple of percentage. I mean, SKF, a Swedish fantastic company, this competition among these roller bearings is so tough. So you only make 2-3%. 20% every year of the turnover as profit, which means that I would always consider SKF shares as a liability rather than an asset. So sometimes things change, I mean, things can move, and being a game changer means you can take those interesting positions first. Telecommunications before continuing. Yes, telecommunications. Now we have the next presentation. Game changing telecommunications. Who is the proud presenter?
Both ladies.
Yes. So the ladies are all on the game changers.
Yes.
So now we have theory. Yes. As an academic, I have to make theories. So maybe presenters.
Yeah, I feel honored to be appointed as the spokesperson. My duty here is only to present. Okay. In telecommunication, I think the current definition now is telecommunication. And then the game changer here is in competition area, it will be coming not the other telecommunication companies that will as competitors, but also the complementary of content, yeah? For example, Yahoo, Google. Yeah? So users, I think, don't care of which telecommunication company will be the carrier as long as they can access Yahoo or Google. Yeah? So the competition here is how you can get content as much as possible. And that leads us to the competition. The competition here, from competition, am I right down there?
Of course, yes. I think everybody has a password, but
yeah. So, from the current telecom is only a telecommunication. We are talking about information telecommunications, right? It's only telecommunication. Now, future, I'm not supposed to talk my mind. The future, the Asia, the vision is becoming the times. Times industry. C is still the telecommunication. I is the information. So not only internet, but also information. Including the virtual data center by cloud. If I am unsure, I always look at cloud. And then when we start nodding, I'm right. Okay. I is information. M is the media. Media here is, for example, like a vision, probably the vision TV, the TV, vision, telecom TV, news TV. E is the edu, entertainment. So it's education and entertainment. So not solely on the education, but also it's an entertainment. And then S is the service. Kind of changing the competition into the O-O, the ocean. And then the goal is to create the digital value by 2021, then digital value and then expansion by 2020. Thank you. So if you have a question, please direct to Pak Ang.
So just curious, what is the main value proposition you would say you have to the global collaborators when you invite the global players here into your Times world?
Yeah.
What's the value proposition to them?
All the parties in the ecosystem to cooperate.
thinking what I would say quite normal, not only is business development. So normally it's quite complicated to move in this direction with a big bureaucratic infrastructure behind it. And as an entrepreneur, you can easily sit in the front seat and define new concepts and ideas. But when you come with a long legacy, normally it takes some time to change the mindset of the decision-making processes internally.
So in the past, we had a wrong understanding of what the telecommunication industry. We always focus on the other telecommunication operator. That is really the most dangerous is not come from the other telecommunication operator, but come from the UPT. So for the cost, this is so why we have to move fast within the adapt to the new organization.
Yep.
We have already had almost 20 subsidiaries to focus on this IMS industry.
Yep.
But it's, yeah, I agree with you, so still, we still have some problem.
Implementation is normally complicated. I mean, within the big framework, because what happens is that decision-making, resource allocation, etc. are still based upon the old logic, which means that every time one talks about this, it can be, everybody might know it on the surface level, but the deep nature what it actually means, it's quite a dramatic change of a company to do from a telecommunication company to do this times company. Yes?
Actually, it's a shift of paradigm for me as well, because it's fun knowing all of the people told me it's interesting. So the future of telecommunication will be, correct me if I'm wrong, it's a bundle of services. Like for example, at home, nowadays people work from home as well, right? So at home, you can do the telecommunication, the information using cloud, for example. You don't need to bring this any longer, right? And then the media, the entertainment and the services is a bundle of services. So that is, I think, what Telkom is offering in the future. So what provider now in Indonesia, all of the services. And even if I leave, or I'm away from home, I can monitor my CCTV from the gate. So probably that is the, before I start eating. Before I was thinking, really? You want to do this five area? And even in one area of communication, you still have a lot to improve and you want to expand. So now
that's what I mean, the communication process
is complicated. No, I do understand it's kind of bundle of services.
I think you homework.